KNDY.
And I believe we are getting ready. We're about 20 minutes behind schedule here. And the first game of the day went to a running clock in the fourth quarter. Thank goodness. I've been waiting for a while. Good evening. Chris Dierking at Seneca. The Hall Central High School is our home for the week as we tipped off the Thunder Classic last night. And second round play continues this evening as the Marysville Bulldogs faced host Nema Hall Central Thunder. It is the 10th annual Tournament Classic here, and we're delighted to have you along on air, online, and on our mobile app. Tip off just a matter of minutes away. We had a longer game in game two today. Here's the progress so far. St. Mary's ran away from Jackson Heights 50-18. As mentioned, a running clock. Holton beat Hiawatha 58-43. That one took a while. And then they had a Shrine Bowl presentation between games, and the kids were itching to warm up and get back home tonight on a wintry evening, as we left early on account of a snow squall warning. I'm not sure what that was all about. We had blowing snow and dropping temperatures en route. A reminiscence of last year, we came over for the championship, and I commented that was the roughest trip to a ball game I had endured in 40-plus years as a sportscaster. The road home was completely different. It had straightened out, but the trip to Seneca was a tall order last year on a Saturday. Again, stay inside where you're at and enjoy the broadcast. Our live coverage is service of our KNDY Sports Booster Club members, Marysville and Nema Hall Central, tipping off in the Thunder Classic tonight. We'll check starting lineups after this timeout.
At Galloway Uyghurs in Brinegar, we're about building relationships, one client and one issue at a time. I'm Jason Brinegar, and I invite you to visit with me for any legal services you might have, including probate, estate planning, and trust administration. Advanced planning has countless advantages to your family, including greater control and disposition of your assets and tax issues that might come up. Call for a no-obligation appointment today. Check us out on our Facebook page or at gwblaw.net.
Croft Family Insurance is here to help you find the right insurance products to protect what matters most to you. As an independent agency, they represent over 80 companies that allow options for the right products at the right cost. See Brian Croft today for home, auto, commercial coverage, and more. Call or stop by at 1119 Broadway, just west of the courthouse in Marysville. Find them online at croftfamilyinsurance.com. For complete coverage and a competitive quote, reach out to Croft Family Insurance in Marysville.
Well, a day late, we got the competition underway yesterday with first-round play as top-seed St. Mary's defeated number 6-seed Holton 69-53. Second-seed Marysville knocked off number 5-seed Jackson Heights 48-36. And in the nightcap, host Nema Hall Central, third-seed, dispatched fourth-seed Hiawatha 49-45. In round-robin play, St. Mary's defeats Jackson Heights earlier today 50-18. And Holton outlasted Hiawatha 58-43. Nightcap here, Marysville versus Nema Hall Central in the first meeting between these two teams this year. Marysville with a win last night improves to 6-3. Nema Hall Central with their victory last night at 5-3. And the starting lineups for the visiting Marysville Bulldogs. Willow Tots, a 6'1 junior. Bryant Seaman, a 6'4 senior. Blake Spicer is a 6'2 senior. Connor Lee, a 5'9 sophomore, and Paxton Vogt, a 5'11 junior. Marysville, a pair of seniors, a pair of juniors, and a sophomore under head coach Scott Brown. Nema Hall Central Thunder will start Evan Olberding, a 5'11 junior. Goldie Free, a 6'8 junior. Trent Thomas, a 5'10 senior. Cooper Kramer, a 5'11 senior. And Abe Hilbert is a 6'6 senior. Nema Hall Central, 5-3 on the season, under head coach John Thomas. Bulldogs and the Thunder tipping off in high school boys basketball action tonight, live on KNDY.
Wait, Santa is done, my friends. After Santa's hard work comes the new Wi-Fi hungry connected gadgets. Make sure your router is capable and ready. Let Blue Valley help you kick off the new year on the right foot and upgrade your Wi-Fi experience. Get 2 months free worry-free Wi-Fi and free installation from Blue Valley Technologies. For more details, visit bluevalley.net/promo.
Have you ever wondered what sets Sunflower Community Credit Union apart from the rest? It's the power of ownership. When you join Sunflower Community Credit Union, you're not just a customer. You're a member and an owner. Sunflower Community Credit Union is a member-owned, nonprofit financial institution that places our members' needs as our top priority. We're here to help you grow your savings, manage your finances, and achieve your dreams. Visit Sunflower Community Credit Union in Marysville, where ownership matters.
Bremen Farmers Mutual Insurance, providing high-quality coverage and service, all at a competitive premium cost. Since 1888, Bremen Farmers Mutual has offered homeowner, farm owner, business owner, fire, and inland marine coverage. Dependable and affordable, see your local agent representing Bremen Farmers Mutual Insurance. Learn more about the various insurance products offered by going online at bfmic.com.
Ag Buildings provides safe storage and working space for farm shops and machinery. Inline Construction offers wood or steel frame ag buildings, complete and finished to your specifications. Call today for a quote and let them get started. For ag buildings, demolition, concrete, and construction work, count on Inline Construction. Find them and see their recent projects on their Facebook page.
When looking for a new ride, you know what you want, but don't always want to spend the time looking. Let Crown Over Auto Sales in Marysville find you that perfect ride. Whether it's a car, SUV, family van, side-by-side, or truck, any make or model, Ethan and Andrew can find it. Swing by the office today, East Highway 36 in Marysville, across from Valley Vet.
Thunder Pep Band warming up the crowd here tonight, and I do mean warming up as that thermometer falls again, and we're back in the icebox for another weekend. Be safe. Be warm, be at home. It's probably just the place to be tonight. Marysville comes on the road 6-3. A pair of losses since the Christmas break to 4A state-ranked Abilene. And then last Thursday, a loss at Wamego. Marysville bouncing back in first-round play here. Took Jackson Heights' team with a solid start. But Heights gave them a contest, notably in that third-quarter comeback. Nemohal Central, they're off to a 5-3 start. Pair of wins after the Christmas break, plus a win in the opening round of this tournament last night. And the Thunder take the tip and possession as Evan Olberton, Colby Free, Trent Thomas, Cooper Kramer, and Abe Hilbert take the court for the Thunder. 6'8", 6'6", inside on maybe the tallest tandem Marysville will face this season. Here's an early charge foul on Trent Thomas, his first. And the Bulldogs take their first possession on the opposition court, left to right. Willow Tott, Brian Siemens, Blake Spicer, Connor Lee, and Paxton Vogt. As Siemens opens with a three-point shot off the near side. Rims off, doesn't fall. Thunder returns. And I will likely call them Raiders a time or two tonight. Marking back to the days when we did a lot of coverage of games here with the translator station in Seneca. And that was Nebohall Valley, as I recall. Foul whistle. Little Top picks up his first. Well, Top was high scorer for Marysville last night, finished with 20, but 16 of those came in the first half. Turnaround by one of their bigs inside, Colby Free with a chip shot in the paint. Breaks the ice. It's an early 2-0 Thunder lead. Just underway in the nightcap. Bulldog basketball. Otot crossing right to left. Matching up one-on-one with Colby Free coming near the lane. Is foul, and it's Free's first. Several early contact fouls here in the opening minutes. Brings Whittle Tott to the free throw line. Bounce off the back of the rim, doesn't fall. Well, Tott, the only starter back from last year's club, graduating 10 seniors off a runner-up finish in Class 3A. They went 23-3. Well, Tott snagged the second look, and it's a 2-1 Thunder lead. Traveling whistle on the far side, but Trent Thomas, coach's son, turns it over. Early substitution is Carter Rottinghouse. He's a 5'10 senior. Bulldog basketball, a service of our KNDY Sports Booster Club members. Hey, we really appreciate their support. Tell them thanks. Max Blaskies and Omega tonight as Twin Valley League coverage continues on our sister station, FM 95.5. Play underneath to Connor Lee. Almost got away. Nice save. Paxton Vogt kicks it out of the paint. Topside two. Blake Spicer missing a three. Evan Olverding on the return. Long layup doesn't go. Chip in. Follow shot's good for Colby Free. And his second score. He stands tall at 6'8". He's all of that. Long, lean, and lanky. Is fouled by Willow Top. That's his second. And the free throw, nothing but net for a 5-1. Nemo Hall Central lead. Two teams didn't face each other in the tournament last year. Marysville fell to Hatches into the championship. They are not in the field this year. Play to a top in the lane. Guarded shot. Rims off. He was fouled. Otop takes it to the paint. Cooper Kramer picks up his first. And Otop's back at the line where he just went 1-for-2. Soft touch, up and good. .606. We're just underway, first quarter. And Otop scores. As Silas Miller, a 5'10 senior, checks in the Bulldog lineup for Connor Lee. Solid bench, not a lot of varsity experience with the 10 seniors on the squad last year, but they came out impressive to start in December, have been state ranked. They're currently ranked number 9 in 3A. Fell Sun after the loss to Wamego last week. Perimeter passes, man-to-man pressure. Here's Evan Olverding checking the free throw line. Play in the paint. Kramer kicks it back out to Olverding. Top of the key three is good. And it's an 8-3. Nemo Hall Central lead. We're at 5:35 to play in the first. Errant pass off the far side. Siemens threw it back to Spicer. He wasn't ready. Over and back violation gives Central possession. Not a big crowd on hand tonight. Obviously, the weather playing a factor. Not even a lot of hometown fans. They're pretty good supporters over here. Thunder basketball are up 5 early on. Paris scores in the paint. Their last basket was a long ball out top. Traveling whistle is a second Nemo Hall Central turnover. Bulldogs yet to score a field goal. 2:45 into this one. Perimeter coming near side to Otop. Will is double team, turns and tumbles near the baseline. It's out of bounds to MHS. Otop will draw a lot of attention defensively. At 16 in the first half, and Jackson Heights put him in check after halftime. Bad pass, Bulldog turnover on the inbounds. For as strong as Marysville looked with 22 points in the first quarter, they were outscored 14-6 in the third. It was literally a tale of two halves. Rolled on to a 48-36 victory over Jackson Heights. Olverding now between the rings. Far side to Free. Checks down low underneath. Kicks in the corner to Olverding. Three, rattle the cage, wouldn't fall. High in the air is Big Colby Free for the board. Olverding takes three defenders in the paint. He was fouled. Evan Olverding to the line. Fouled by Paxton Vogt. It's his first. Olverding, first free throw tonight. It's good. Connor Lee is in the Marysville lineup again, along with Garrett Haberkamp. He's a 6'4 senior, seeing his first action. Chance to extend the lead to 7, and does. Olverding with 5. 10-3 Thunder. 4.5 to play, first quarter. Not pressing. Pass down low to Lee. Over two defenders. Shot missed. Nemo Hall Central wearing their home whites here tonight. Marysville's actually the higher seed. How that's decided, I guess. Gentlemen's agreement. Typically the higher seed is home team, but makes a lot more sense seeing them in their home whites on their home court. Foul whistle on Garen Heberkamp is first. Brings Trent Thomas, a 5'10 senior, to the line. And with his first missing, Thunder are now 3 of 4 at the stripe. Here's Carter Hack, a 5'11 sophomore in the Thunder lineup. Both coaches have gone 7 deep in the opening 4 minutes. Second charity on the way is good. It's 11-3, and the Bulldogs yet to score a field goal. And an awfully slow start offensively in that loss at Wamego last Thursday. Otot comes to the top of the key. Unguarded three, missed. Three is high for the rebound. Listed 6'8", with arms that reach the rafters. And if he gets off the ground at all, he is way above the other guys out there. Hayek, not challenged, outside the arc. Picks up coverage on the far side. Free, play in the paint. Down low to Mead. Hildert, shot doesn't fall. He's the other of the two tandem tall boys. Mead Hildert at 6'6". Bulldog basketball. We're down to 3 minutes and counting. Still no field goal. Hesitation for Ryan Siemens. Now Otot plays the dribble left, then right, to the paint, just below the free throw line. Otot off the glass for two. It's 11-5 Central. Thomas scooting around defenders. Down low on the near side. Was fouled. Silas Miller picks up his first. Team foul number 5 puts us at the line in the deuce for Trent Thomas, 1 for 2 earlier. Free throw miss. Blake Spicer, Paxton Vogt, checking the Marysville lineup along with Jordan Miller, a 5'10 junior. He's number 8 off the bench. Derek Wirtz, a 6'5 junior, checks in for the Thunder. Second free throw is up and good for Thomas. And it's 12-5. Bulldogs back to a top. Checks far side. Double team. Spicer top of the key. Lee gives off to Miller. Around the horn, far side to Otot. Double team baseline. Turning away, lost control of the ball, but he was fouled first. Carter Rottinghouse picks up his first. Fourth team foul. Max Blaski, Twin Valley League coverage at Onega. He's got a pair tonight and 4 back-to-back tomorrow. Continuing coverage on BNDY FM 95.5, on air, online, on our mobile app, as we're in those marathon weeks for basketball. Willow Todd coming down low, picks up his second field goal, and he's got all 7 Marysville scores. 12-7, 2 minutes remaining. Hayek out between the rings. Pass right side. Down low to Gilbert. Willotot takes a charge. From Big Abe Hildert, that's his first. Team foul number 5. Goldie Free is back in the lineup for Central. Bulldog basketball. Down 5. Otot challenge just below the free throw line. Siemens gives back to a top now in the forecourt. Near side, Miller off right wing to a top. Check of the lane, nothing doing. Black jerseys far side, Miller from the corner. Otop in the forecourt. Short passes.
And she thinks I'm uncool when I yell as the waiter goes by. I like beer. It makes me a jolly good fellow. I like beer. It helps me unwind and so.
KNDY.
Mr. Miller, we'll let you sing later. What happened there? Gremlins in the works, I guess. 12-7, Nemo Hall Central leading Marysville. Clock under 45 seconds. Connor Lee near side traveled with the basketball, coming into a pass. And a strong Central start here tonight. Scott Brown sending Bryant Siemens back in the Marysville lineup. 40 left in the first quarter. Central on a 12-7 lead. 4 of 6 free throws for Needle Hall Central here in the opening eight. Driving right side, Trent Thomas comes into traffic. Shot missed. Collision and a foul whistle. Derek Works picks up his first. And we're in that double bonus. Rule change this year, each quarter a foul reset. After five contact fouls, and the teams go to the free throw line for a pair. And it's Bryant Siemens at the stripe, first time tonight. Chance to cut a five-point deficit, he does. As Silas Miller checks back in. We're at 27 seconds remaining. Siemens, left-hander, puts it up strong off the backside. And Hyatt pulls it down for the rebound. Thunder can play the clock out. Speak of rule changes, optional 35-second shot clock in the works for high school teams next season. Clock under 10. Hyatt passes to the paint. Crashing through traffic is Derek Works. He was fouled. Whistled on Paxton Boat, his second. 2 each on Willow Top and Paxton Boat. As Derek Wirtz comes to the line, and his first is good. That's 8 Nemo Hall Central free throw opportunities, and they've hit 6 of them. Almost half their point production. We're at 5 seconds remaining. Wirtz strong on the follow. Spicer brings it down. Otop to the forecourt. Launch. 3 steps off the arc. Bounces off the rim. And 1 quarter in the books from the 10th annual Thunder Classic at Seneca. Nemo Hall Central 13, Marysville 8.
Farmers, they're the lifeblood of America. The men and women who tackle the toughest jobs to put clothes on our backs and food on our tables. They might do it quietly, but their genuine values and tireless work ethic are an inspiration to us all. Some might say farming is a thankless occupation, so that's why we're taking the time to say thanks. Farm Bureau Financial Services, protecting what matters most.
Patrick Booty in Marysville is your local agent with Marshall County, Farm Bureau Insurance, and Farm Bureau Financial Services.
United Bank and Trust has been fulfilling the banking needs of families and businesses in Northeast Kansas for decades. United Bank and Trust is always advancing, and now they'd like to offer a free mobile deposit feature within the mobile banking app. Endorse, click, and submit your check image for deposit. It's a mobile-fast world out there, and so is United Bank and Trust, the bank of your future. Visit our website at ubankonline.com or your local branch for more information. United Bank and Trust, banking for your way of life. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Free CPA in Marysville has built a heritage of trust and reliability with your accounting, tax, and business advisory needs through the years. Certified public accountant Marcus Fries, with over 25 years of experience, and his staff continue that tradition of outstanding service to you, the customer, each and every day. Free CPA, downtown Marysville.
Bulldog miss out of the far side corner opening second quarter play as Nemohal Central has a 13-8 lead with the ball. Carter Hyatt goes low. Backdoor effort doesn't fall. They kick it out top on the offensive board to Evan Olberding on his second tray in the contest. Olberding with 8 points, and it's 16-8 on a double-up lead for Nemohal Central. Traveling whistle is a Marysville turnover and a difficult start for the Bulldogs as Scott Brown sends three substitutions in. Awfully reminiscent of a disappointing start in Wamego last Thursday that really never got better. Such a strong start for Marysville last night versus Jackson Heights. Aaron Pass flies out of bounds on the baseline but stays with Nemohal Central. Central at 5-3, losses to Sabetha, Harry LeCompton, and St. Mary's this season. 8 foot away, shot missed by Colby Frey. Otat's been the only scorer from the field, and that's just a pair of field goals. Now in 9.5 minutes. Otat near the lane. Waited it out, had a couple defenders in front. Finally pitched the underhanded shot and got the foul whistle on Carter Hyatt, his first. Otat's back at the line, 3-for-4 tonight, and misses here. Marysville simply has to generate some balance offensively, relying so heavily on Will Otat. Upper 20s for an average. Miss again. Tussle over in the corner there. Plays out of bounds off the red and black. Still more substitutions off the Bulldog bench. Otat's out there with Jordan Miller, Brian Siemens, Garrett Haverkamp, and Blake Spicer. Pretty much back to the starting five. Some starting role adjustments here in recent games. Colby Frey from the corner missed. Thunder keeping it in play on the offensive board. Looking solid here on the start on their home court. Driving the lane. Evan Olberding was fouled. Mason Rader picks up his first. And Olberding, 2-for-2 earlier, now waits at the line. It's good. Nothing but net. Central now, 70% on 10 free throws. Olberding, second look. Rims off. 8 Hilbert whistled for his second personal on the rebound attempt. Central 17, Marysville 8, or if you will, Central 17, Otat 7. Otat, top of the key. Now Spicer. Hands to Otat. Triple team near the paint. Kicks it out far side. Shots up and good for Marysville's Mason Rader. Rader for the tray. The Bulldogs' third field goal trims the lead to 6. 5:40 left, first half. Fans starting to make a little noise here. Up top is Rottinghouse on a double dribble whistle. Time out on the floor with 5:33 remaining. Nemohal Central 17, Marysville 11.
Alliance Insurance Update. The first step of our move is now complete. As previously reported, we are now located at 715 Center Street on Highway 36 between New China Buffet and Impulse Archery. Dottie Rose made the trip with us and is right outside our front door. In the spring, we will be moving to our new permanent home back on Broadway. We will keep you posted when that move happens. So for now, from the girls at Alliance Insurance, thank you so much for your continued patronage, and we look forward to serving all your insurance needs today and every day. Stop by 715 Center Street or give us a call at 785-562-2393.
The winner in this is back in the championship Saturday at 1, the consolation Saturday at 11:30. And we'll see how it shakes out. It's a round-robin tournament, so I'll have to sort the matchups after the game tonight. Shot missed, play by the Bulldogs. Kicks it out front to Raider, missed a three. Holdy free, brings it for the Thunder. With a long pass down the floor, intercepted by Brian Siemens. Bulldogs showing some signs of life. They just need some life offensively. Single score in the second stanza. We're 3 minutes into that. And here's a pass to the lane. Knocked away, gets taken away. Carter Rottinghouse brings it back. 17-11. Scott Brown is nearly a part of a team out there on the floor coaching right alongside the ball handlers. Perimeter passes, far side. Free holds it high by 6'8". I do mean high. Holberding coming to the near side. Hilbert down low. Back to Holberding. Wide open in the corner. Missed a three, but he was fouled. We'll have three free throws coming. Blake Spicer is first. Olberding's free throw is good. He's 3 for 4 now. And two more coming. Extending that lead back to 7. Middle of the second quarter. Number 2 is good. 9 of 19 points are free throws for this Nemahal Central Ball Club. Derek Wirtz, reserve, checks back in for the Thunder. Olberding missing. Heberkamp pulls down the board. Just 3 field goals in almost 12 minutes of basketball for Marysville. Here's Blake Spicer driving inside. He had a couple of nice drives last night, as I recall, early on. Spicer and Siemens took some early charges to the lane for scores. Spicer to the stripe. Foul call on free is his second. Spicer connects. Here's Trent Thomas, starter back in. Spicer can cut the lead to 6. And it's good. Reluctant, but good. Connor Lee will check in. They had started the inbounds pass, but gave him clearance. So we'll reset on the inbounds with 4:17 to play first half. Thomas comes across midcourt, met by Siemens. Takes the dribble far side. Bounce out to Olberding. Olberding backs it out. Thomas far sideline. Olberding again between the rings. Turns it out, all the while clock rolling at 3:50. Thunder really spreading that offense, sideline to sideline. Olberding in the middle, following a screen. Whistled for an offensive foul. It is Derek Wirtz, it's his second. Here's Mason Raider back in the Bulldog lineup. 19-13 Thunder. 3:39 to play first half. Time of possession greatly in favor of Will Ochant. They rely on him heavily. Ochant, top of the key. Pass far side to Siemens. Missed off the side of the rim. Boards out to Derek Wirtz. Play in the paint, ahead to free. It's good. Rottinghouse with the assist. Colby Free on his third field goal extends the lead 21-13. And there's 3 minutes and counting. Far side Spicer. Otai. Turning left of the lane. Fires a pass past Mason Reeder out of bounds. Bulldog turnover. Garrett Haverkamp checks in. Honestly, hard to see this struggling start for a 6-3 Marysville team. Defense holding their own. Offense hasn't been there. Free comes around left side. Pretty quick for a big tall guy. Kicks it out top to Thomas. Near the line works. Underneath. Turnaround chip is good for Trent Thomas. Thomas' first field goal. 10-point Thunder lead. Here's Otak going far side. Seaman back into forecourt. End of a near side, hand off to Otak. Lost his dribble. He reached out ahead. The ball was stolen by Carter Rottinghouse. He missed the layup. There was a foul on the follow shot. Whistle on Connor Lee is his first. That's three Marysville team fouls, bringing Evan Olberding back to the line, where he's 5-for-7. Make it 6-for-8. Carter Hayek's in the Thunder lineup. Nathan Reeder checks in on the other side. Olberding for a second free throw to extend the double-digit lead. Missed. 1, 2, 3 Marysville field goals in the first half. We're near halftime. Otak needing help. Turns, pitches it back to Lee. Connor in the forecourt. Far side to Siemens. Siemens left alone. He needs help. Marysville has to take timeout just to hang on to possession. Buck and a half left, a minute 30 in this first half. Nemahal Central 24, Marysville 13.
At Reflections, you will find a treasure trove of items and gifts backed by a friendly and knowledgeable staff. Shop your Hallmark Gold Crown store for the biggest selection in greeting cards, Christmas ornaments, gift wrap, home decor, and gift ideas for all your celebration and personal needs. In addition, Reflections offers custom framing services and specialized Black Squirrel products, along with your favorite K-State and KU fan gear. Shop Reflections in downtown Marysville today.
There is a difference, a lot of difference.
When it comes to financing your operation, you want to deal with someone who knows agriculture. Our loan officers are experienced in ag lending. Get your ag loans here. First Commerce Bank. Experience the difference. Member FDIC.
Well, I don't know how to say it in the kindest way, but Marysville almost looks scared out there tonight. They're not handling the ball well. The offense just hasn't been able to perk at all. Three field goals, and we're down to a minute and a half left before halftime. Nemahal Central not doing anything that extraordinary. Teams on paper should match up pretty well. Size-wise, everything about what you'd expect. Bulldog basketball. Thunder's coming out a lot more aggressively. They're double-teaming the ball handlers. Lee on the near side. Otak fouled on the baseline. They are really stepping up pressure, trying to force turnovers. Whistle on Derek Wirtz, his third. Brings Will Otak to the line, where he's 3-for-5 tonight. Down to a minute 13 to play first half here. Both teams advanced with wins in first round play yesterday. Otak connects. And Will on a second look. Rims off, doesn't fall. Collision underneath on the rebound. Blake Spicer's first. Haverkamp checks in. That's four team fouls. We're not at the line as yet. Thunder by 10 with the ball. Very confident start for the home team here tonight. These teams will meet again a week from tomorrow. Driving the lane through traffic is Trent Thomas, his second score, and it's 26-14. A three-point bucket and three free throws in the second quarter for NHS. Otak is up top directing traffic. Left of the free throw line, settles for a shot, missing, and it's hauled out by Evan Olberding with just over a half minute to play. Thunder may play the clock out here. Again, these two teams meet next Friday. Marysville girls are here tomorrow night. We're told no earlier than 7, probably 7:30 or so on the tip for varsity action. If you don't want to brave the cold, we'll make the trip and we'll have it live. Clock under 10. Coach Thomas wants timeout. Can't get his team's attention. Rottinghouse, left side, Hyatt. Coming underneath, left side, baseline. He's fouled by Blake Spicer, his third. Cutter Hayek at the free throw line, first time tonight. Extending the lead with 0.4 of a second left. Point difference. Double up lead now, 28-14. Bulldogs won't get a shot off coming inbounds at the buzzer. Our score at the half from the Thunder Classic in Seneca. Hall Central 28, Marysville 14.
When you own a business of any kind, you need an insurance policy that'll protect it. You need business insurance that perfectly suits your industry, and Blue Valley Insurance is proud to offer it. When you get an insurance policy from us, you're taking the first step towards protecting your business, your employees, and yourself. Let's start with an overview of the types of coverage you can expect. Stop by for quotes at Blue Valley Insurance in Lynn, Greenleaf, Hanover, and Marysville.
For reliable trash pickup and roll-off service, call on Temps Disposal. Containers sized to meet your needs for residential, commercial, and construction jobs. Always prompt and professional, Temps Disposal serves Marshall, Washington, and Gage counties. Let them go to work for you. If it's their weekly collection schedule or one-time pickups for construction, moving, or cleanup, Temps Disposal in Marysville is a phone call away at 785-562-5360.
Napa Know-How.
Locally owned, locally operated, your Napa Parts store in Marysville offers Napa Parts and accessories, plus the tools, equipment, and supplies you need to get every job done right the first time. The right tools at the right price, plus Napa Know-How. From your locally owned and locally operated Napa Parts store in Marysville, Enan's Automotive.
Napa Know-How.
Right now, one in three drivers is cruising around in a state of skepticism about just how much value their car insurance company is delivering. If you're one of them, State Farm agent John Bannister can help you get to a better state. He'll talk with you, listen to you, and help put together a policy that has you written all over it. From cost to coverage, see John Bannister, 1022 Broadway in Marysville today, and get to a better state.
Derricking with Bulldog Basketball on air, online, and on our mobile app, KNDY, KNDYRadio.com, and, of course, worldwide on that free mobile app. It's 28-14, Neal Hall Central leading Marysville. It's almost as if the second-half hangover from last night was a carryover tonight. Marysville versus Jackson Heights had a 22-9 first-quarter lead. Marysville was up 20 at the intermission. and then simply fell flat in the second half as Jackson Heights came out 14-6 in the third quarter, but Marysville had enough of a lead to hold on for the win, 48-36. Tonight, nothing insofar as a start offensively. Settling for three, counted three field goals in the first half. Willow Todd has two of those, 8 points, two field goals, and 4 of 7 free throws. After that, Reserve Mason Raider with their only tray. Blake Spicer, a pair of free throws. Bryant Siemens adds a free throw. As Marysville settles for 8 in the first, 6 points in the second quarter, first half total of 14. Nemo Hall Central, pretty good balance. Evan Olberding's got a couple of trays and 9 points to lead the field. Trent Thomas with 6. Colby Free with 5 points. Off the bench, Carter Hayek with a pair of free throws. And Derek Wirtz adds 1. 13 in the first, 15 in the second. First half total of 28. Nemo Hall Central leading Marysville 28-14 earlier today in the tournament. Top seed St. Mary's ran past Jackson Heights 50-18. That was a running clock in the second half. Holton outlasted Hiawatha 58-43 in game two. And here in the nightcap, Nemo Hall Central leading Marysville. This leads to Saturday's finals, tipping off at 10 a.m. I believe that'll be Jackson Heights Hiawatha. And in game two at 11:30, I believe Holton will take on the loser of this one. And then in the championship Saturday at 1, I believe St. Mary's will take on the winner of this one. It's round robin, so I always hesitate calling those before I absolutely know. We'll find out anyway if Marysville plays at 11:30 or 1 o'clock. I believe 11:30 with a loss tonight, and 1 o'clock if they come back to win. Either way, we'll be here tomorrow night with girls varsity action around about 7:30. And Marysville's boys back in play here on Saturday. Hey, good luck to Cole Fredrickson and the Marysville wrestlers. They had a makeup duel tonight with Clay Center, hosting North Central Kansas League foe Clay Center Tigers in the Junior Senior High Activity Center. I expect they're about to wrap that up. Jayhusker tournament was canceled on account of weather last weekend, as so many of these tournament games were moved back. Just a lot of revisions. I'll leave it with that. A lot of revisions across Kansas and Nebraska with a resulting snowstorm and incredibly cold weather that I guess they say is coming back. 28-14 at the half. Thunder lead the Bulldogs.
When you roller, send for Schroeder.
For complete body repair, see Jeff at Schroeder Collision Center. A family business for several generations, let Jeff and his quality crew help you with your auto needs. Schroeder Collision Center, 701 Carolina, 562-3546.
Kickafer & Bussing, certified public accountants in Marysville and now in Seneca, are qualified and available to assist you with all of your income tax and accounting needs. Stop by and visit Ken Kickafer, Kent Bussing, or their staff of certified public accountants and paraprofessionals. For prompt and friendly service, contact Kickafer & Bussing at their two locations, 1100 Broadway in Marysville at 562-2100, or 508 Main Street in Seneca at 336-2400 to set up an appointment. Kickafer & Bussing, where quality begins.
Agriculture. Our country was built on it, our children are fed by it. No one quite understands the unique needs of the farmer like United Bank and Trust. Whether you raise crops or livestock, you need the right equipment at the right time. Our ag loans can help you acquire and maintain that equipment when and where you need it. Contact one of our experienced ag lenders today. United Bank and Trust. Banking for your way of life. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
Anyone can sell you soybean seed. Channel Seedsman place products to perform. With Channel ExtendFlex soybeans and Channel Roundup Ready 2 Extend soybeans, you'll get the superior weed control you want and the high yield potential you need. Make the most of next season with the Roundup Ready Extend crop system and expert recommendations from Channel Seedsman. Ask a seedsman in your area for recommendations for your fields. Check with your state pesticide regulatory agency for specific restrictions in your state. Always read and follow pesticide label directions.
Planning new construction? If it's an outbuilding, storage, home addition, or a new home, the pros at Hometown Lumber in Marysville and Axtell Lumber will help you put together everything you need from start to finish. They can help you with your design with recommendations and cost estimates, helping you find the right product at the right price. And it's delivered free for you when you're ready, when you shop local. Everything you need for your dream home or a simple shed is at Hometown Lumber in Marysville and Axtell Lumber. Visit with them today.
Glad to have you tuned in tonight. A busy week of basketball action. Again, Max Blaschke's in Onega again tonight. He's got a pair of games as the Valley Heights girls beat Lynn in the opener. Valley Heights and Hanover boys, I believe, in the nightcap on FM 95.5. He'll have four games back-to-back in the semifinals beginning at 1 o'clock. Nope, 1:30 tomorrow afternoon. And we'll be back here again with a loss, I believe, at 11:30 and with a win to play the Saturday championship at 1 o'clock. Here's the fine print on the bottom of the bracket. We'll adjust Saturday's consolation games accordingly to avoid repeat contests. Marysville's got some makeup work to do to get back in this contest. Central leading 28-14. I didn't mention free throws, but Marysville 7 of 11 first half, while Nemaha Central is 12 of 18. So much of that 14-point deficit is 12 free throws for Nemaha Central. That said, second half action straight ahead. Stay tuned.
Just like our area athletes work each day in practice to perform at their best in the big game, the staff at Bruna Implement Company, your local Case IH dealer, work daily to provide the best parts and service experience when you need it most. Bruna Implement Company has been family-owned for three generations. We know what it takes to be successful as your area Case IH dealer. For the best in farming equipment with the service to back it, there is only one. Bruna Implement Company, since 1947.
At Kramer Oil, safety always comes first. We're here to keep your home and shop warm with reliable propane delivery, which is why with your first fill-up, we perform a complimentary leak check. Your safety is our top priority, so you can rest easy knowing we've got you covered. And we're not just about safety, we're about convenience too. Need propane when you want it at a fair price? Call or text us today at 785-562-2466. We're here to serve you.
Hop in, let's go to Honeyman Ford in Seneca, the best place to be.
Skip the drive. Come see us right here in Marysville, Kansas. At Honeyman Auto Sales and Service, you'll find the same honest sales experience backed by the same reliable service. With the same goals in mind, our Marysville location is sure to provide you with a satisfying vehicle experience. Find us on Facebook or stop in at 1122 Pony Express Highway today.
Have you driven a Honeyman Ford lately?
Have you ever wondered what sets Sunflower Community Credit Union apart from the rest? It's the power of ownership. When you join Sunflower Community Credit Union, you're not just a customer. You're a member and an owner. Sunflower Community Credit Union is a member-owned, nonprofit financial institution that places our members' needs as our top priority. We're here to help you grow your savings, manage your finances, and achieve your dreams. Visit Sunflower Community Credit Union in Marysville, where ownership matters.
Second-half starters for Marysville. Willow Todd, Brian Siemens, Blake Spicer, Mason Rader, and Rick Wurtenberger get the start here in the second half. Wurtenberger seeing his first action, his number 9 off the Marysville bench. Olberding, Free, Thomas, Kramer, and Hilbert starting 5 back for John Thomas' team. It's 28-14, Omaha Central with possession, playing the home court right to left. Driving underneath, Thomas pitches to the opposite baseline to Hilbert. He'll come outside the paint. Shot rims off to Bryant Siemens. Bulldog possession. They need some unanswered baskets to get confidence back. Otop turning near the lane. Out top, Blake Spicer missed off the heel of the rim. Olberding pulls down the board. Long pass down the floor, Thomas. Underhanded layup, doesn't fall, hits the base of the backboard, in fact. Bouncing off to Blake Spicer. Just underway, second half. Boys basketball action tonight. No time. Two steps away, his man-to-man defender is Evan Olberding. Pass from the corner, comes underneath. Out to the near corner, Mason Rader missing. Colby Free picks up the board. Neither team scored. Early second half. Pass to Abe Hilbert. And he was fouled. Blake Spicer picks up his third. There's Derek Haverkamp checking in for Spicer. A lot of fouls in the first half, sending Central to the line 18 times. They hit two-thirds of those. Man-to-man D. Free almost tripped up on his long, gangly legs on the near side. Plays it cross court to Trent Thomas. That's a three-point basket for the score. Thomas has nine. It's 31-14. Now 6-10 to play. Otan, left of the lane, double team, kicks it out top. Three-point shot missing for Siemens. Three field goals for Marysville in the ball game tonight. 2 minutes into the second half. To the far side, Kramer. Down low to Free. Chip shot is good for Colby Free. He's got seven. Thunder extending the lead, 33-14. Outscoring Marysville 5-0 here in the second half. Otot coming to the lane. Evan Olberding picks up a first personal. Bulldogs key it in from baseline. Got away from Haverkamp. Fight for the loose ball. Couple of players lock arms there. Mason Rader goes to the court with Trent Thomas. Connor Lee is in the Bulldog lineup. Neither team gaining traction out here in the second half, so to speak. No shot from the right side of the free throw line. Shot was blocked by Abe Hilbert. And the Thunder take it away. On a 19-point lead. Hilbert shot blocked by Willow Top beneath the basket. O'Top takes it away. Dip for tap. Out top, Blake. I should say Bryant Siemens with a miss. Thomas on the return. Hilbert. Guarded layup's good. Braid Hilbert's first score. 35-14. And the hole gets deeper for NHS. O'Top tripped up in the forecourt. Maintains his dribble. Reach-in foul. Evan Olberding. Yeah, Olberding's second. Middle of the third quarter. Scott Brown's having a little visit with the official here. He's frustrated with the coverage on Otan out in the forecourt. They really are giving him a time. That conversation continues. Here's Olberding again on a push foul. Called by the official who was visiting with Coach Brown. Here's a substitution. Carter Rottinghouse in. Now, Scott's going to continue that conversation with the official. He's beside himself trying to find an answer. Top of the key three, missing for Siemens. Ain't nothing falling for Marysville. Nothing. Three field goals. We're almost 2.5 quarters into this ball game. Haverkamp checking in for Wartenberger. Central, solid start, solid performance. Working far side of Rottinghouse. Out top, Hilbert. Thomas checks the lane. Long layup missed. Haverkamp knocks it down, but there's a foul whistle. Fouled by Trent Thomas, his second. Blake Spicer will check in along with Jordan Miller. A lot of player rotation, trying to find a spark. 4:10 left, third quarter. 35-14, Neenah Hall Central. Marysville scoreless in the second half. We're over 4 minutes in. Otot fighting traffic in the lane was fouled. The whistle on Carter Rottinghouse is second. That's 14 fouls. And Otot's back at the line. He was 4-for-7 in the first half. 8 points tonight. Well off an almost 28-point average this season. If you were wondering, the conversation with Scott Brown and the official continues. Miss. Can't even buy free throws tonight. 7 of 12. Otot missed again. So he's 50% from the line tonight. Marysville defense stepping out deeper in the forecourt on Rottinghouse, far side. Crossing to Hilbert. Kramer in the forecourt. Near side back to Rottinghouse. Near the paint, Trent Thomas. Double pumps, shots up and good for the coach's son. Thomas knocks down his second field goal since halftime. 37-14, 3:15 to go. Nice give inside. Crossing the lane, Jordan Miller plays to Blake Spicer underneath for the deuce. It is Marysville's fourth field goal tonight. And they're down 37-16 with timeout. We've got 3:03 left to play, third quarter.
Be prepared for the 2024 hay season and save during CanEquip's annual twine and net wrap sales event. Preseason pricing on genuine CNH twine for round balers and square balers, small or large. Plus Armor Net, Legacy, Bale Keeper, American Net, and new this year, Varsity Net Wrap. Place your preseason order at CanEquip in Marysville.
CanEquip can. CanEquip can equip you.
Well, I'm kind of taking a glance back. What have been low scores for Marysville? Last week at Wamego, a struggle. They managed 38 points in a 50-38 loss. 47 points in the loss to Abilene. Went to OT with Concordia. They had 52. 16 points for Marysville. We're 5 minutes into the second half. Trent Thomas got popped in the chops, but is whistled for a foul on his third personal to check out. Got hit in the mouth. Not sure how he took the whistle, but it did. Otot was out for just a moment after the timeout to catch his breath. He doesn't get much time off the court. Evan Olberding failed to check in. Now they're sorting it out. Trent Thomas came out with a cut lip. And now they're trying to manage several substitutions. Can I go home? Second seed Marysville on the ropes here tonight. You like the records in this field, though, this year. All very similar teams. Pitch to the far side, and a three is flat for Blake Spicer. Thunder with the board and a 21-point lead. They were up 14, a double-up score at halftime. Pass deflected, far sideline out of bounds. Axton Vogt checks in. Thank you. Thunder basketball. Rottinghouse takes the dribble near side. Plays a bounce pass intended for Hilbert. It's stolen by Spicer. Blake with a takeaway. Otot drives the court. Plays in the lane and is fouled. A pair of free throws coming for Will Otot. Carter Rottinghouse picks up his third. Forwarding Thomas are starters with three fouls each. Rottinghouse and Wirtz are reserves with three fouls each. Otot is 5 for 10 at the stripe. His teammates are all over here at the bench as he connects. .221 to play in the third. 20-point ball game. Otot trims it to 19. Here's Brian Siemens in. Full court press now. Olberding turning near midcourt. Coming across the timeline. Bumps Paxton Vogt to the court. Paxton picks up the whistle. His third. Vogt and Spicer at three fouls each for Marysville. Doubling up the intensity defensively. Defense hasn't been the bigger problem tonight. It's lack of offense. But you do what you can. Play to Abe Hilbert underneath. The assist to Cooper Kramer. Hilbert's second score, and it's 39-18. A minute 50. Third quarter. Fake out of the corner by Siemens, coming underneath. Pitched off to Vogt. Not before a foul is whistled as Evan Olberding picks up his fourth. Mason Rader in the Bulldog lineup. Trent Thomas checks in for Nemo Hall Central. Here's Siemens on the free throw. It's good. Thomas came out of the game moments ago, had a cut lip, something along those lines. Siemens, second look. It's good. He's 3 for 4. Timeout with a minute 47 left. Third quarter, Nemo Hall Central 39, Marysville 20.
Update your home today with a new look from Feldkamp's Furniture Mart. See their tremendous selection of living room, dining room, and bedroom sets and furniture, as well as bedding, accent pieces, appliances, and more. Financing options for any budget up to 24 months with no interest, as well as free delivery, making buying local easy. Shop Feldkamp's Furniture and Flooring in Marysville today.
Bulldog Basketball, a service of our KNDY and our regional Sports Booster Club members. Busy week of hoops as we missed school Monday, Tuesday. Bumped everything back a day or two. Some tournaments across the state canceled entirely. I don't think this latest snow squall was supposed to be substantial enough, but the cold temps are coming back heading into the weekend. Tournament director's nightmare. Inbounds pass, stolen by Blake Spicer. Here's Will Otot for a three, miss off the near side. And the Thunder take it back, leading by 19. Turning into forecourt, Trent Thomas. Near side, Carter Rottinghouse. Split defenders, he was fouled by Brian Siemens, his first. 14-5. Team fouls not as much a factor on the change with the foul situation this year. In the Euro, reset every quarter, then a double bonus after 5 fouls. Soft touch near the lane, missed by Colby Free. Otot brings it to the paint, bounced off a defender, he was fouled. Guarded by Cooper Kramer, it's his second. Otot's back at the line with 1:17 remaining. Let's not rattle the cage, wouldn't fall. Upcoming is 14th free throw here tonight. He's hitting a half of them. It's good. Jordan Miller checks in. It's 39-21. Thunder. Commanding lead on their home court. They're 5-3. Marysville 6-3. Foul on the inbounds pass. Blake Spicer's fourth. And this puts us in that double bonus. Trent Thomas to the line. 2-for-4 in the first half. Shooting a pair here with still a minute 17 on the clock. Free throw's good. The first game had a running clock in the second half. Game two went long. This one's been a long one. More ways than one. Second shot by Thomas is good. He's got 13. 20-point Thunder lead. Marysville, a single field goal in the second half. Four field goals tonight. Turning down low, taking the final whistle. Paxton Vogt. Now it's an offensive foul on Vogt. Oh, boy. Vogt, Spicer, four apiece now. Full court pressure. Thomas hustles down with a strong dribble. Thomas maintains in the forecourt. Far side to Kramer. Outsider circle finds Rottinghouse. 45 seconds remain. Far corner, driving. Derek Wirtz bumps a couple of Bulldogs to the court. And Wirtz picks up his fourth personal foul. Four each on Wirtz and Olberding. Three on Thomas and Rottinghouse for Nemaha Hall Central. Brent Wurtenberger checks back in the Marysville lineup. And Carter Hack comes in for Nemaha Hall Central. 13-8, Nemaha Hall Central at the end of one. They led 28-14 at the half. Up 20 points here. Coming to the close of his third quarter. Wurtenberger near the free throw line. Back to up top. Out of the corner. Jordan Miller, strong off the back of the rim, doesn't fall. What are we hitting here? About 10% or are we in the single digits? There haven't been a lot of shots put up, but nothing has fallen. Clock under 10. Catching up with himself. The ball got away. The Bulldogs steal it with 4 seconds. Allen still in back by Rottinghouse. He's fouled. There's the buzzer. We got a free throw opportunity coming first, I think. They had to whistle before the buzzer. And it's Jordan Miller's first. Bringing Carter Rottinghouse to the free throw line. They're going to add just a little bit of time to the clock. Can't be more than a second or two. And will it really matter in a 20-point ball game? They settle on 1.8 seconds. Will it matter? Rottinghouse to the line. This is 21 free throws now on the night. 18 in the first half for Central. Rottinghouse missed. They just did beat Hiawatha by 4 points last night. Second win over the Redhawks this season for Central. Rottinghouse missed, so Tott with the board launches from half court at the buzzer. End of three, Nemaha Hall Central 41, Marysville 21.
How would you like to have a steady job with a schedule that works for you and your family? You're in luck. Tension is hiring operators and adjusters at the Marysville plant. If you like to take things apart and put them back together again, if you enjoy being part of a team, if you're looking for flexible work with competitive pay and benefits, this could be a great match for you. Work for a company you know you can trust. Visit tension.com/careers to learn more and apply.
Tires aren't all the same, and neither are tire dealers. Find a dealer like Mike's OK Tire, who carries Michelin and BF Goodrich tires.
Michelin offers safe, fuel-efficient, long-lasting tires that provide exceptional performance and extraordinary value. BF Goodrich tires are built for drivers looking for high performance and aggressive styling. Next time you need tires, don't deal with amateurs. See the tire experts. See Mike's OK Tire in downtown Marysville for tires, repair, alignment, and service.
Since 1976, Olmsted Real Estate and Auctions has been your farm and home marketing team. Let the experienced family team of Tom and Rob Olmsted and brother-in-law Tom Kirkland guide you when buying or selling a home or farmland. Delivering timely, honest, and professional guidance, visit olmstedrealestate.com to view current listings and auctions. Your farm and home marketing team is Olmsted Real Estate and Auctions.
Sold 300. That's buyer 5-2.
Nemaha Central leading 41-21 has outscored Marysville each of three quarters. 13-8, 15-6, 13-7. Marysville has scored four field goals tonight. Three in the first half, a field goal, and four free throws in the second half. We're underway fourth quarter, a 20-point lead, and Nemaha Central's going to play clock. Going corner to corner with his offense, which might become a topic on a 35-second shot clock that will be optional next year. Teams will have the option of playing the entire season with or without. They're going to try it out and see if it moves the games along. I don't know, for better or worse, we'll give it a shot. Marysville with a loss, I believe, would see Houghton at 11:30 on Saturday. Nemaha Central, if they win, would take on top seed St. Mary's in the championship at 1. That unless Marysville can overcome a 20-point deficit. But we've only got 7 minutes left, and Nemaha Central's not giving up possession. John Thomas, sport coat on tonight, hands in his pocket, has to be pleased with his team's performance. Going to Carter Hayek underneath for the deuce. And it's 43-21. Here's Willow Todd with 11 points tonight. Three off the far side for Jordan Miller. Second score off the bench. Second tray here tonight. Field goal number 5. Thomas to the lane. A little off guard. The defender stepped away. Trent Thomas wisely goes to the hoop for the deuce. Now 45-24 is the team's trade baskets. Almost a throwaway traveling whistle on Jordan Miller, but it wasn't without his trying. Blake Spicer had run past a pass. Sakes alive. Connor Lee, Paxton Vogt in the Marysville lineup. Bulldogs with a strong start in December. They've lost twice here since the Christmas break. Abilene, Wamego on the ropes here tonight. Thomas had the ball knocked away. Whistle Willow Ton, his third. First and a half. 6-10 remains. Inbounds, far side, Kramer. Brings it to the forecourt. Man-to-man coverage. Kramer maintains dribble. Takes it to the hoop, down low. Gives off to Colby Free. Throwing it back in the forecourt to Trent Thomas. I'll be content to improve to a 6-3 mark on the season. Just wearing time. Turnaround, fadeaway, near the paint, doesn't drop. Bulldog basketball. 10 points for Marysville here in the second half. Out of the corner. Shots up and good for Connor Lee. And a couple of scores for Marysville. But it's late with 5:20 remaining. Simply said, Marysville has to play with some consistency. I know that was a comment Scott Brown made after the loss last week at Wamego. Have to be consistent. Thomas to the lane for 2. 17 for Trent Thomas. Consistency and then some offensive diversity. Cannot rely on Willow Tott entirely. Defense took him out tonight, and it shows. Miller off the far side missed a three. Persistently launching the long balls. I like the early on offense last night. Saw Spicer and Siemens going inside. They're 6'4", 6'2". They should compete, at least to some degree inside. Easy to be the armchair quarterback, I know. 20-point affair here, middle of the fourth. Holberton gives to Thomas in the forecourt. Maintains the dribble, right hand, left hand, back to right. Holberding out front. All the while, clock rolling at 4:20. We may take a media timeout here. It's 47-27. Central leading Marysville. Playing clock with 4:15 to play in the ballgame.
Norris Motor Company in Marysville has a one-owner new truck trade. It's a 2022 Chevy Silverado 1500 model High Country Edition. They have a 2022 1500 LTZ71 package under 13,000 miles, as well as a 2023 Buick Envision Essence, awaiting your test drive at the Nordis Motor Company in Marysville.
When you're building, make the local choice with Cromie Lumber. Close to home, spend your time working and not fetching. Easy pickup or delivery available, and their prices are competitive on all of your building needs. From lumber to siding, roofing, paint, windows and doors, to the tools to get the job done. Make the easy choice the first time with Cromie Lumber, Marysville and Washington. As always, they appreciate your business as they work to help you save time and money. When you're building, make the local choice with Cromie Lumber.
After a long stretch of burning clock, Aide Hilbert took a pass underneath. His basket waved off. He's whistled for a foul, his third. It's 47-27, right where we left it. 3.5 minutes remain. Rhett Wurtenberger's shot blocked by Colby Free. Ball is tipped to Carter Hayak. He's fouled on a missed layup. Carter Hayak to the line for a pair. Jordan Miller picks up number two. Hayak at the line. First of two is short. There's Blake Spicer in. Teams match up again a week from tomorrow night at the boys' standalone fair next week. Marysville girls are in tournament play at Hiawatha. Hayak connects. By the way, the girls' team opens Monday with a tip-off. They're back in action on Thursday. They play Jacksonites Monday, Topeka Hayden on Thursday night. Far sideline shot missed by the Bulldogs' Jordan Miller. Now there's 3 minutes left. Central leading by 21 points. Thomas near side, fouled. Siemens second. Oh, I'm sorry. Mason Rader picks up his fourth. Catch up on that, I guess. Trent Thomas to the line. Thomas 4 for 6 tonight, missing here. Hold on, basketball. And you try to bounce back. Short turnaround with the tip-off Saturday. Likely be an early tip at 11:30. In the paint. Shot missed for Spicer. No look give underneath to Abe Hilbert. He missed the shot. He was fouled. It was the give that was impressive. Connor Lee's third. Hilbert's at the stripe, first time tonight. 21-point Nemo Hall Central lead with 2:37 left. Hilbert connects and we'll be back.
If you're 50 or over, it may be time to switch your auto and home insurance. The AARP Auto and Home Insurance Program from the Hartford is now available through the Copeland Insurance Agency in Marysville. Discover rates, benefits, and service designed for AARP members, plus extra savings when you insure both your auto and home. Call the Copeland Insurance Agency in Marysville at 619-6220. That's 619-6220. Or visit copelandinsurance.net. Certain policy features not available in all states. Applicants are individually underwritten. Hartford Fire Insurance Company, Hartford, Connecticut.
Hilbert got them both. Nemo Hall Central's biggest lead in the ballgame, 50-27. And the ball got away baseline. Scoots away from Marysville's reserves. Reserves in the lineup here. John Thomas going to counter and send a bunch of his substitutions in. Player rotation timeout with 2:17 remaining. It's 50-27 Central.
Begin your new year with a new career at Landall in Marysville. Currently accepting applications for experienced assemblers, welders, painters, and a net developer. You cannot beat the benefits Landall offers. Wages start at $16 up to $21.20 per hour with a $2 an hour shift differential for second and third shift. 4% attendance bonus, promotions, raises, all-inclusive medical plan, paid time off and paid holidays, weekly paychecks, and more. Apply online and learn more at Landall.com or call 785-562-5381 for more information. Landall Company is an equal opportunity employer.
RX Drug Store in downtown Marysville is here for you. With over-the-counter medicines for cold, flu, and allergy season, and prescription drugs for more serious matters. They also offer curbside pickup and delivery services. Don't forget to bring in your new insurance card for the new year with RX Drug Store.
All right, let's learn some new names and faces here. Both teams wholesale substitutions as we're conceding this one. 50-27, Nemo Hall Central. Leighton Thomas is a sophomore ball handler out in the forecourt to Carter Rottinghouse. Top of the key to Derek Wirtz. Down low shot missed by Rottinghouse. Wirtz with a board in the paint. He was fouled. Leaving a minute 58. Nemo Hall Central leading 50-27. The foul whistle on Marysville's Chandler Fink. Bringing Derek Wirtz to the free throw line. He hit one of two early on tonight, missing here. 23-point lead, Nemo Hall Central's biggest. They've led throughout. 13-8 at the end of one, 28-14 at the half. Another miss, and the rebound's hauled out. Matatis Wassel. Here come the Marysville reserves. Connor Lee. Far side to Wassum. Top of the key, Asher Wassum. Near side, Silas Miller coming to the lane as the ball swiped away. With a minute 40 left, Marysville will fall to 6-4. Nemo Hall Central will improve to 6-3. Both teams back Saturday. Marysville 11:30 as far as I'm guessing. And Nemo Hall Central in the championship would meet St. Mary's at 1. Pass to the paint, taken away. Tip to Connor Lee. Pair of field goals, fourth quarter. 6 field goals tonight for Marysville. And a miss for Silas Miller on the far side. A rematch between these two in 8 days. Be interesting how Marysville reacts coming back next week. Following a screen, far side is Carter Kramer to Rottinghouse in the forecourt. Again, playing keep away for the remaining 40 seconds. May Test girls are here tomorrow night, about 7:30, I'm told, for the varsity tip. If they're on schedule, we'll have it on air. Shot missed by Leighton Thomas, and a foul stops the clock at 27 seconds.
Derek
Wirtz fouls out of the ball game for the Thunder. Scored a free throw early on. Carter Hayek back in. Bulldogs' lowest point performance this season by a long shot. That is Lawson out top of the key. Connor Lee missed a three. Rebound was pulled down by Jack Mackey. He couldn't hang on. It's out of bounds to the Thunder. Inbounds to Rottinghouse. And the ball knocked away by Silas Miller. So on day two, top seed St. Mary's beats Jackson Heights 50-18. Holton outlasts Hiawatha 58-43. And Nemohal Central will knock off Marysville, our final, 50-27.
It's your land. You know what you need to run your farm operation. And it's a lot more than just seed and soil, livestock and farm machinery. That's why we're here to design a plan that fits your farm, your family, and your life. We're local and we're here to help you grow. Stop by and let's talk. Citizen State Bank, Marysville, Waterville, and Hanover. Member FDIC.
We're just making a living, making things grow.
At Kramer Oil, safety always comes first. We're here to keep your home and shop warm with reliable propane delivery. Which is why with your first fill-up, we perform a complimentary leak check. Your safety is our top priority, so you can rest easy knowing we've got you covered. And we're not just about safety, we're about convenience too. Need propane when you want it at a fair price? Call or text us today at 785-562-2466. We're here to serve you.
Hop in, let's go to Honeyman Ford in Seneca, the best place to be.
Skip the drive. Come see us right here in Marysville, Kansas. At Honeyman Auto Sales and Service, you'll find the same honest sales experience backed by the same reliable service. With the same goals in mind, our Marysville location is sure to provide you with a satisfying vehicle experience. Find us on Facebook or stop in at 1122 Pony Express Highway today.
Have you driven a Honeyman Ford lately?
Planning new construction? If it's an outbuilding, storage, home addition, or a new home, the pros at Hometown Lumber in Marysville and Axtell Lumber will help you put together everything you need from start to finish. They can help you with your design with recommendations and cost estimates, helping you find the right product at the right price. And it's delivered free for you when you're ready when you shop local. Everything you need for your dream home or a simple shed is at Hometown Lumber in Marysville and Axtell Lumber. Visit with them today.
Generations have relied on Kinsley's of Marysville, the Patton Funeral Chapel in Frankfort, Hanover Mortuary, Ward Funeral Homes of Lynn in Washington, and Landreth Axtell Funeral Home. You can continue to rely on the professional experience that they provide and the heartfelt concern that they offer each family that they serve. Caring concern in your family's time of need.
And our final, Nemohal Central 50, Marysville 27. And they did announce that Saturday, Jackson Heights and Hiawatha tip at 10. Marysville faces Holton at 11:30. And Nemohal Central will host St. Mary's in the championship at 1 o'clock. So we'll be back for an 11:30 tip-off Saturday and back here tomorrow night with Marysville girls action as tournament weeks continue. Tough, tough night for Scott Brown's team. Outscored all four quarters, 13-8, 15-6. 13-7, and 9-6 down the stretch. Marysville scattered just 5 field goals on the night. Nemohal Central, good balance, led by Trent Thomas with 17. Evan Olberding, 9 points. Colby Free with 7. Abe Hildreth finishes with 6. Carter Hayek, 5 points, and Derek Wirtz fouled out late with a free throw. Central with a win, improving to 6-3 on the season. Marysville's Willow Tot with 11 points. Blake Spicer with 4. 3 each for Brian Siemens and Connor Lee. 3 apiece off the bench for Mason Rader and Jordan Miller. Bulldogs with a loss fall to 6-4. Nemohal Central 50, Marysville 27, our final here tonight. Stay tuned. Scores from the Twin Valley League Tournament and around the area on our Farm Euro Insurance Scoreboard Show. Sponsored game nights by Farm Bureau agents Patrick Beauty in Marysville and Bryce Leonard in Washington. Score updates on our morning, midday, and evening sports report as well Friday. Tournament week continues. Drive home safe if you're out and about. Snow coming in, blowing snow, and colder temperatures into the weekend. We'll keep you warm and inside with coverage of Bulldog basketball continuing Friday night, Saturday morning, live on air, online, and on our mobile app. Bruce Dierking saying thanks for listening. Have a great evening. Stay warm, everybody.
At your service 24/7, on air, online, and on our mobile app. News, weather, sports, and more. Yours from KNDY.